Hey guys, Jen here from Main Street USA, and today's vlog is going to be something a little different. This is going to be the first in a series of vlogs that cover all the quick service meal options in the parks. And obviously, I'm starting with Magic Kingdom. Now, if you go on the Disney website, quick services cover everything from like the sit-down quick services to just the walk-up windows. Today we're doing just the ones where you can get actual meals with your dining plans. So I hope you're hungry, because this is going to be a delicious adventure. Is Casey's Corner, right here on the corner of Main Street USA.
And if you do the mobile order pickup for Casey's Corner, you're gonna head over this way. And the entrance is through this door right here, which is just past the standard queue. Here at Casey's, they offer a bunch of different hot dogs because this is based off like what you would get at a baseball stadium. So they offer a chili cheese hot dog in foot long or regular, bacon macaroni and cheese hot dog in foot long or regular, corn dog nugget meal with cheese sauce, which looks amazing and someday I'll actually get it, and a plant-based slaw dog for $11.49. That is their vegetarian option. It does not contain animal meat, dairy, eggs, or honey. And then they just have a monthly special hot dog, which I didn't see anywhere what the monthly special hot dog was or special loaded fries. They also have chili cheese fries and bacon macaroni and cheese fries. They also offer a toppings bar where you can get jalapenos, relish, onions, or sauerkraut to go with your dogs. They do only have a very small seating area indoors. Most of the seating for Casey's is outside. I remember years ago when they didn't have tables at all and they only had bleachers. The outdoor seating area for Casey's is quite large because there is a only limited amount of indoor seating area. And you also may get a little show because sometimes they play on the piano there.
This is new. The spring roll cart has moved. It used to be all the way back by Tiki Room. Now it's right here at the entrance to Adventureland. And today's special is pepperoni pizza. I am not even anywhere near Jungle Cruise, and this is the start of the Fast Pass line for Jungle Cruise. That's insane. Next stop on our trek is the Tortuga Tavern in Adventureland. And this one is right across from Pirates of the Caribbean.
Tortuga Tavern, their food will have more of a Caribbean flair. Here in Tortuga Tavern, they offer a jerk smoked brisket sandwich, a ropa veja, which is like slow cooked beef, a turkey leg, a hot dog topped with the brisket or ropa veja, a regular hot dog. And then for desserts, they offer plantain chips served with black bean salsa or a rum cake. In the side room is not only this amazing poster of Blackbeard, but over here by the fireplace, this is where one of the rounds of Sorcerers of the Magic Kingdom is played. The other nice thing is they offer bathrooms. Most of the seating here at Tortuga would be considered like an indoor-outdoor or covered outdoor seating. There's no true indoor seating here.
Next up is the Golden Oak Outpost. Now this is more of a quick service stand. However, because you can get a full meal on the dining plan here, this one will be included in this video.
So here at Golden Oak, you can get a chicken breast nuggets meal, loaded onion rings, or chili cheese waffle fries. They also have two specialty milkshakes, a dulce de leche and Rocky Road. They only have a very small outdoor seating area. However, you could take your food and use either some of the seating at Tortuga Tavern or the one directly across at Pecos Bill's. In 1878, with the encouragement of his friends, Pecos Bill decided to open his own watering hole, a restaurant whose motto very much reflects its one-of-a-kind owner, the tastiest eats and treats this side of the Rio Grande. Pecos Creative's Bill called it the Tall Tale Inn and Cafe, and it quickly became a popular hangout for some of his legendary friends. As time went by, it became a tradition when each friend paid a visit, they would leave something behind for Pecos Bill to remember them by. As you can see from the articles and artifacts that don the walls, many of which carry inscriptions, Pecos Bill had some mighty impressive friends. It seems that every trail eventually led to the Tall Tale Inn and Cafe. They offer a veggie rice bowl, plant-based Southwest cheeseburger, bacon cheeseburger, jerk chicken lettuce wraps, a fajita platter, a Southwest salad, beef nachos, or a taco trio, and you can choose three out of the different options they have. For kids' meals, they offer a cheeseburger, rice bowl, mac and cheese, beef nachos, or Uncrustables. They also offer for sides tortilla chips with queso dip, guacamole, cuties 3-packs, yellow rice or black beans, and for desserts, they offer churros with chocolate dipping sauce or Dan and Greek yogurt. Pecos Bill's has a massive toppings bar with sour cream, tomatoes like a corn salsa, cheese, lettuce. They have a standard salsa and almost like a pico de gallo. And then if you get like a burger or something, they just have pickles, onions, jalapenos, or lemon if you get iced tea. Pecos Bill's also offers mobile order pickup, which is done right in the center in between the ordering stations. Pecos Bill's does have a very, very large seating area. It encompasses several rooms, so there is usually plenty of places to find an indoor seat here. Inside, they also offer restrooms as well. Since most of its seating is indoors, they only have a very small area for outdoor seating. And now that we're entering Liberty Square, we have Sleepy Hollow refreshments. Again, this one is more of a stand than like the sit-down quick service, but you can get full meals on your dining plan, so that's why we're including this one as well. Here at Sleepy Hollow, they offer a sweet and spicy chicken and waffle sandwich, a foot-long corn dog, funnel cake with powdered sugar, Mickey waffle with powdered sugar. That one, if you get it with the strawberries and whipped cream, is amazing. Vanilla ice cream churro sandwich, a fresh fruit waffle sandwich, which comes with a Nutella spread, or a breakfast egg and cheese waffle sandwich, which is only served until noon. There is also a small seating area just outside Sleepy Hollow. And this building right here is our next stop. This is the main quick service. Are you done? Every time I try to vlog out here, the Columbia Harbor House, and this is the spot Jeremy has decided to eat today. So we're actually gonna be waiting in line and getting some food. So Columbia Harbor House offers a bunch of different options. They have combination platters where you can get either fried shrimp and frit and fish, chicken breast nuggets and fish, chicken nuggets and shrimp, or a trio platter, which is all three, fried shrimp, fish, and chicken nuggets. They also have a lobster roll, the Lighthouse Sandwich, which is hummus with tomato and broccoli slaw served on toasted multigrain bread with house-made chips, chicken breast nuggets, a tuna sandwich, and a grilled plate, which comes with grilled shrimp or grilled salmon. They offer a chicken pot pie or the harbor salad. For kids, they offer a tuna sandwich, Uncrustables, a garden salad with chicken, chicken breast nuggets and fish, just nuggets, or macaroni and cheese. They also offer harvest chili New England clam chowder. They have sides of french fries or hush puppies, macaroni and cheese, vegetable rice or green beans and carrots. Columbia Harbor House has seating both upstairs and downstairs. The seating upstairs is really cool. There is a ton of it, and it's shaped like you're inside of a sailing ship. So there was a super long line, so we did a little bit of a cheat. We just walked right in, grabbed a table, and then did our mobile order. So now we can sit here in the air and wait until it's ready. So if you're coming into order, you order on that side, but for mobile order, you just walk right up here. So our food was ready. That literally only took about 5 minutes. But Jeremy got the nuggets and shrimp. It does come with two sides, so he got french fries and I got hush puppies, and then for $3 you can add on a side of macaroni, and that's what I did because this is my favorite mac and cheese on property. Next stop on our tour is here in Fantasyland, and that'll be the Pinocchio Village House. So this is nice. Outside of Pinocchio Village House, they have some water refill stations,
where you can get cups of ice water, and they do have a small outdoor seating area where you can take your food and sit outside. And I like that this one has a set queue for entering, so it just kind of keeps the seating area from getting too congested. And there's Pinocchio pictures, paintings, murals all over the walls. I love how the lighting makes it look like you're outside. So this is one of the best lit quick services on property.
So the Pinocchio Village House offers flatbread pizzas, chicken parm and pasta, chicken parm sandwich, chicken breast nuggets, an antipasto salad, or penne pasta with marinara sauce. For kids, they offer a pasta with marinara sauce, Uncrustables, turkey sandwich, chicken breast nuggets, just 4 pieces, a pepperoni or gourmet cheese flatbread. For sides, they have french fries, breadsticks with marinara sauce, an antipasto salad or tomato basil soup. And for desserts, they have a tangled wall eclair, Dan and Greek yogurt, or chocolate gelati. A fun thing about Pinocchio Village House is if you sit by the Small World ride, the window overlooking it, you can request special cards. These cards have actions that you can hold up for the riders of the ride to do. So it's a fun way for kids to pass the time getting the riders of the ride to interact, to give high fives and do the Macarena and things of that sort.
Next stop here in Fantasyland is the Friar's Nook. Same thing, this is a more of a stand type, but since you can get full meals on the dining plan, we're including it.
Here at the Friar's Nook, they offer creamy bacon macaroni and cheese tater tots, an all-beef hot dog with tater tots, loaded buffalo chicken tots, or a bratwurst with tots. And that comes on a pretzel bun, and that looks like something Lee would love. And it looks like for the Bratton tots, they have a plant-based version also.
Now they do just have a small seating area outside, and it fills up very, very quickly, so it's kind of, you have to find somewhere to sit when you order here. So I am here outside of Be Our Guest restaurant. On the website, this is listed as a quick service for breakfast and lunch. However, due to its popularity, you have to make reservations for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. It is still a quick service style meal for breakfast and lunch. Dinner is a full sit-down dining credit. So just so you're aware, you cannot walk in to Be Our Guest as a quick service like you do with the others. You have to book it in advance. Next up is Gaston's Tavern. Though it's not really known for its food, other than the gigantic cinnamon bun, it does have sandwiches that you can get, and you do use a quick service meal. So this one's on the list as well. So here in Gaston's, they have the refillable water stations as well with the free ice water.
Here at Gaston's Tavern, they offer a smoked turkey and Gouda sandwich, a ham and Swiss sandwich, a fruit and cheese picnic platter, their famous warm cinnamon roll, or a chocolate croissant. They also offer a trio of assorted macarons, mini Baby Bell snack cheese, sliced apples with caramel sauce, celery and carrot sticks, or hummus and pretzel chips. And of course, they also offer LeFou's Brew, and you can also get it regular or with the souvenir stein.
Because this is Gaston's Tavern, you know he uses antlers in all of his decorating. They do have a very small selection of seats, but there's one seat in particular that I love in here. They have Gaston's chair here, and this is an awesome little photo op. Then as we enter into Tomorrowland, we come upon the next stop on our list, Cosmic Rays Starlight Cafe. Now Cosmic Rays has one of the largest seating areas out of all of the possible places to eat here. And if you eat indoors, it even comes with a free concert from Sunny Eclipse. So it's a little insane in here, so I'm not gonna be able to get up to the actual menu, but I got a paper one we can look at.
Here at Cosmic Rays, they offer a bacon cheeseburger, the Mickey cheeseburger. They have a foot-long hot dog, a grilled chicken club, chicken breast nuggets, Greek salad with chicken, or a plant-based sloppy joe. Seeing the Mickey cheeseburger on the menu is interesting, because this was only supposed to be a limited time item as a birthday celebration burger, but it seems like it was so popular that they've permanently added it to the menu, which is brilliant, because this cheeseburger is delicious. Then for kids, they offer Uncrustables, a kid's salad with turkey, chicken breast nuggets, or mac and cheese. For sides, they have chili cheese fries, french fries, or just a cheese dip to dip your fries in. And for dessert, they offer s'mores.
And last stop here in Magic Kingdom is the Lunching Pad at Rocket Tower Plaza. Same thing, even though it's a walk-up, You can still get full meals and use your dining plan, so it counts towards today.
Here at the Lunching Pad, they offer a sliced roast beef sandwich, a Mickey pretzel, or an all-beef hot dog. They also offer a cream cheese pretzel or a churro with chocolate dipping sauce, and they also have a Space Ranger slushy, which comes with a candy straw. Interesting.
So one more thing to take note before we head out today is this is the Tomorrowland Terrace restaurant. It is no longer listed on the Walt Disney World app or website as one of the quick service options. It's only listed under the Happily Ever After Desserts Fireworks. So I don't know that this will ever be opening as a quick service again. So sad. All right, guys. Wow, that trash can's really hot. That's gonna do it for this incredibly busy vlog. Holy cow, there were so many people here today. But again, this is the first in a series of four, so I will make it to all four parks to show you all the quick service options so that when you are ready to come down on your trip, you have all the information you need to know. But if you guys like these videos, please click that subscribe button, tap the like, and ring that notification bell so you always know when a new video is headed your way. Thank you so much for watching, and now we're on to the next adventure. Bye, guys!